Funding now on Indiegogo, it's Shadowbinders, our second chance offer to get two hardcovers of our classic webcomic delivered to your door. Steampunk, fantasy, and romantic comedy from Clownfish Comics. Go to Indiegogo, check out the link in the description below. Now on with the video. Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Neon. I am here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And we're going to talk about Twitter fandoms being called out by the media as being toxic. Now, this article is about K-pop fandom, but they talk about stans. And they talk about it like it's unique to K-pop fandom.
It's not.
And it's not. We'll talk about that. We're going to talk about how awful cartoon fandoms can be, and movie fandoms, and it's not just unique to K-pop fandom, but
K-pop's pretty bad, though. I'm gonna tell you.
It's pretty bad.
I'm gonna tell you anyway.
But you know, the media is starting to call out stan culture, and they need to, because this is where the cancel culture comes from. This is where the stalking comes from. This is where people are harassed. It comes from stands.
People don't like your fan art. They tell you to kill yourself.
Yeah.
And the suicide rates are up. People are already upset and depressed. If you have a bunch of people harassing you and telling you to kill yourself, people are doing it.
Yeah. Yeah. It's crazy. It's infiltrated the art communities, the animation communities, comics, all of this on the Venn diagram of crazy. It all comes down to Twitter and stan culture being just absolutely toxic, but at least the media is starting to see it. The mainstream media is starting
people
to see it.
People need to go outside and get lives more.
They do. And then you find out it's just like some 14-year-old girl.
Usually.
Or a bunch of them.
I'm not trying to be mean, but usually usually skews younger, yes. And then you don't have to say anything to them because they're a kid. They say, I'm a kid. It's like, well, I don't care. You just said bleep, 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 bleep and told people to kill themselves and everything else. I don't care if you're a child. You know, you put it out there, you're going to get crap back.
They always do that. They always, you've gotten in so many fights with these.
I can say what I want, but you can't say anything because I'm a kid. It's like, oh, honey, I'm a teacher. You know what? Don't even.
Bend over and take the paddle.
You know, don't even.
We used to get paddled at school with an actual wooden paddle with holes drilled in it.
Yeah, because it would hurt more.
I'm not kidding. Those were the days. You know what? We minded our manners.
People were respectful, People were respectful.
Before we get into it, please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants, guys. We're over 181,000 subs. Thank you for the support. And we have talked about cancel culture at length. We've talked about cartoon toxic cartoon fans. And it does seem to center on stan culture. And stan culture kind of grew out of, I think, Tumblr, where you had hyper fans, super fans, taking it to the next level where it became obsessive, and then they would start, you know, attacking other fans.
Irony, I think they mostly left Tumblr and now they're all on Twitter. So you probably go back to Tumblr and you probably won't get bothered too much.
Probably not.
You should go back to Tumblr.
People said Tumblr's actually not too bad now. But this was actually mainstream media. The Review put this up. K-pop fandom is toxicity incarnate, but it can be applied to any fandom. You know, they talk about how Twitter, since the writer was 13 years old, that there have been fans, but the K-pop fans are the worst. They said much of the negativity from K-pop fandom is superiority. Fans fight with each other over whose group is less toxic.
Yeah, they do. It's funny. It's like, I'm more humble than you. No, I'm more humble. I'm the most humble. It's like, kind of like that, but with toxicity.
Right. Fans who seek to defend harmful actions perpetuate the idea of K-pop over morals. One example is Sowon, a member of K-pop girl group G-Friend, who posted a picture posing with a Nazi mannequin. Yeah, you're not allowed to do that. You're not allowed to do anything remotely like that. BTS doing a photo shoot at the Holocaust Memorial, you're not allowed to do that. But they basically are...
Why would you do that?
I don't know. Apparently, they don't have very good PR, these groups.
Maybe because
maybe
culturally it isn't the same. I don't know. I don't want to go assume that because I'm not them, but it seems like really, really bad idea just the whole way around.
I have to wonder, because they talk about how they, you know, instead of canceling the groups, and this is where the cancel culture came from, was actually stans. Like, it's almost like having obsessive sports fans. Like, I'm rooting for my team, but I need to, like, destroy your team for my team to win. And historically, like, geeks have always argued over stuff, but it's never been as bad. I mean, for all
not
this
talk, destructive, yeah.
No, for all this talk about You know, the boys keeping the girls out of the clubhouse and da-da-da-da-da in comics. It's never crossed a line that I can remember where it would bleed over from Twitter out into the real world and have real world consequences mm-hmm. where people would lose jobs and get harassing phone calls.
Yeah, they would call their work and try to like say that.
Well, shove on their doorstep.
They said K-pop fans' age ranges from young teens well into someone in their 30s, creating a wide variety of experiences. Younger fans are much more impressionable and more likely to spread misinformation and bandwagon hate. No shit.
Yeah.
I can tell you, yeah, I've seen that many times. I can't tell you how many times, especially the Shiris. A lot of them are like kids, and if you say anything, they come at you and they try to like harass you. And then when you say, when you give it back to them, you can't tell me, I'm a child. I'm a kid. I'm like, I don't care. If you want to, you know, take on somebody that you know isn't, then and you're gonna claim that you can't say anything. Bullshit. You're on there. It's public tweets. You have to be over a certain age at that point. It's fair
yeah.
game.
Yeah, yeah, and we've seen it, and it has become more toxic, and we're seeing it now that there are real world consequences to these fan wars, and the hashtags again trending. And you know, I think Gina Carano was the victim of that kind of push, where it's not like you're not allowed to disagree. The person you don't like, you're going to basically hashtag them out of existence.
Well, that's like that one girl that was trying to argue with me, and then there was no discussion, no nothing. She just, you know, you're just uneducated, and you're ignorant, and you're wasted, you're a time waster. I tried to talk to her. No, you didn't. I like this. It's interesting, too. Selective exposure to psychological theory related to media communication, et cetera, et cetera. They said, but pre-existing views, it reinforces pre-existing views while avoiding contradictory information. So you're in an echo chamber.
Yep.
Oftentimes, they'll ostracize an idol for some situations solely because they don't like the idol or group based on their own personal views. It doesn't matter the situation, but they will do anything to get to in their favor to drag the idol, creating an uncomfortable an online environment. Fake stories, panic, and incorrect quotes. Oh, so this is everything that we've been saying.
And it's, again, this is not limited.
No, it is not limited.
It's not limited just to K-pop. I think it's because K-pop is like the perfect storm of
well,
this.
Cartoons are too. It's the same. I think
it's the same mentality
and age level and everything. It's the same thing. It's just somebody stands a cartoon, somebody else stands a K-pop group.
Yeah, fake stories, panic, and incorrect quotes spread rapidly, make fans and idols alike create bad online personas. You know, and this goes back too that people have said, well, I was like Chris Pratt. They were trying to say Chris Pratt was saying stuff he wasn't actually saying and making up stuff.
Well, I was thinking, like when the Shiva thing came out and people like me who just said, I don't like the design, it immediately was, that was already immediately said, it was because you're misogyny, racist, all this other shit. And you know what? No matter how many times it's been proven otherwise, they keep repeating the same damn thing. It's like, you know, like a hive mind cult.
And that's, well, that's basically that's,
no, it's exactly
what they're saying.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. That's what I'm bringing up.
Yeah, said the fandom's not always bad. They've had many positive experiences where they haven't felt judged. That's the thing, too, with cartoon fandoms is that they're not all bad. It's just, unfortunately, the bad ones seem like they get the biggest microphone. They mm-hmm. get the most
stop giving it to them.
Yeah, but we see the same kind of thing. They try to get a hashtag trending. They try to get it. They're trying to cancel cartoon characters. They're trying to cancel voice actors. They're trying to, and it is. It's this stan culture bullshit. It crept into Star Wars with the Reylos.
Yeah.
You know, and it's just.
This is why I always say you're allowed to like it. You're allowed to not like it. It's no big deal. And I'm just so tired of being told that you are not allowed to disagree. And it's I'm sick of it. And if you don't agree, then they're going to harass you, going to chase you, they're going to do whatever they can do, try to vote your videos down, mass flag things, whatever, acting like a bunch of children because they mostly are. And yeah. They aren't chronologically children, they're intellectually children or, you know, socially children. And it's just, you know, it's the stupidest thing I've ever seen. And then they're telling people to kill themselves or fan art and stuff like that.
Yeah, I mean, we've seen that from Steven Universe fans.
Yeah.
Again, not the vast majority.
I think that one started getting big. The Voltron Steven Universe was really started. And Adventure Time was where it really started to get really bad.
And it wasn't that bad at first. Like, even the Steven Universe fans, they weren't that bad at first. But again, it's that Tumblr is where I think a lot of the stan culture gestated. And then it did. Because you get K-pop fans that are naturally into animation and anime and other pop culture stuff, and it all kind of blends on this Venn diagram, and it becomes infectious, and then the whole fandom becomes infected with this bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, people need to call this behavior out. I think a lot of these people that participate in this are going to be really, really embarrassed in 10 years are going to look back and be like, God, I can't believe I'm so stupid. And if they
age out of it, because some people are just so emotionally stunted from the internet and and the culture they've associated with, they might not. But hopefully they grow out of it.
Yeah, I think as creators, you know, you have to recognize that, like, I mean, sometimes there's nothing you can do. People, you're gonna have these kind of toxic fandoms grow up around your stuff. Other times, if you see the shit going down, you need to tell people to knock it off.
Yeah, pay attention to your kids so they don't end up like this.
Yeah, actually pay attention. Yeah, parent your children so they're not on the internet all the time harassing adults out of a job.
Yeah, if we start seeing that, you know, our kids don't behave this way, but if we do start seeing any indication that that's the case, there is a discussion had where we pull up actual data and facts to, you know, to discuss it and be like, no, this is not okay. Huh? It's never okay to behave this way, and here's why you're not going to get away with it.
Right. So I think we're going to wrap this up. I just thought it was a really interesting article. I'll put a link to it maybe in the comments and pin that. You can go read it for yourself. This is coming from like a reformed K-pop stan. And it is just Twitter. This is Twitter. It's been overrun. Mm-hmm. So
obviously from the picture.
Obviously. Look at that bird run. All right.
Does this fly?
We'll talk to you later.
Bye.